H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Whatever you see here, it is basically a full of breakfast. And moreover here, it's easy to understand over here. In this simple diagram, I can understand that. I know here from the client, they requested that give me daily dispatch, and server has responded saying the daily dispatch. You know, when we look at here, it is easy to understand. But here, this client is nothing but our script, our VU script. Okay, this is nothing but our VU script. And here, I'm saying only one request, give me daily dispatch. Okay, just to understand this concept, I'm saying only one request and I'm saying only one response here. But here, technically, this request may be divided into different requests. Here, in this daily dispatch, this today only might be one request. And this tech deals, cash and deals, this is a separate request. Okay, all together request combines a complete page over here. That is where we had a web underscore concurrent underscore start, web underscore concurrent underscore end, which today, if you closely observe that particular logic over there, see here we can find something like, let me open actions. Yes, I think we are in actions. Now see here, if you see here, there is web underscore concurrent start over here. So it is been trying to ask something here. This particular part, this all underscore MIN underscore 2 may represent one of the objects here in the application, one of the portion of the application here. Okay, here to theoretically to understand, this is simple. Client is sending a request and server is responding. But here in request, maybe here the request may be small request. Each object, each thing in our application may have a small request here. Okay, now see here, this is one of the requests. This is one request. Okay, this is one request. Okay, this is one request. This is one request. And this small request, this request may be represents maybe this only this daily deals. Okay, and here this request, this particular portion, this whatever the highlighted portion that I have mentioned, this particular portion may represent only this particular portion over here, this particular highlighted part. Okay, together all these small requests combines this entire page. Okay, that's the reason, not only this entire page, maybe a particular portion of the page. Okay, that's the reason you have multiple web underscore starts and multiple web underscore ends here. So you can see something like .js files. .js files means basically JavaScript files. Okay. And even you can see some JPG files over here. JPG file means, what is the JPG file? It may be some image, right? And if it is saying that some 26.jpg here. We'll try to find the, if we have an image with having some 26.jpg. Can you see it? It seems it is find something over here. Actually, this is whatever I have opened is called as a developer tool in Internet Explorer. Okay, here I'm trying to find something called 26.jpg. Seems it is open something here, I'm not sure. It here, it is having something like some 26.jpg here. Okay, so it seems you know, as I said earlier, here it has been recorded each and everything here in the application. Okay, and here it is having something ME or C deals underscore green underscore deals some PNG. Probably this might be there here in the this particular page over here. So what I'm saying here, for each part in our application, basically a request here, a small request here. So even it is trying to highlight the same thing here. Might be this is going to have this one only. Okay, let me click here. Let me try to find. Where is it recognizing or not recognizing? If it is a Firefox, you would have understand easily. It's not changing. But however, here the simple thing is here in whatever we have in the application, each spot is might be a request. Okay, the particular request has been recorded over here. Okay, now here what we have to know over here, under which part this request, I said this request may be small request, and this request may have a JS request. Okay, the request may be JS, JavaScript request, maybe JPG requests. Okay, so here this is a request. A request may be JS, JPG, and PNG here. So here you have to look at each request response here. Try to understand my terminology over here. Try to understand my statement over here. I'm saying that we have to look at each and every request response here. We have to look at each and every request response. We have to look at each and every request response. Why I have to look at a response of each request? In other words, response we have to look at. We have to look at the response of each request to find some uniqueness, to find some unique value, to find some unique value here. And by making use of this unique value, you can conclude that you reached so and so page here. Probably you may not understand right away, I know. This is a kind of a confusion. Let me show what actually I'm talking about. See here. These are the different requests here. Say here, after I clicking on this daily deals, here I wrote the logic like sort organization daily deals. So after we click on some daily deals over here, what you have to do here, probably this is a request. Okay, this is a request that you are sending. Now you have to look at the response of this particular request. And see if you can find some unique information here. Unique information means, once you click on this daily deals, you are coming to this particular page. In this particular page, probably if you can see this particular daily deals, you can conclude that you reached this particular daily deals page over here. Now, or maybe if you see this top auto deals, or maybe if you see this some Apple flash sale, or limited time events, or eBay deals, if you can see this particular text, you can conclude that, yes, you reached this particular page. Now, how can I conclude whether this particular text is been there or not? This text is nothing but it is a part of one of the response. Try to understand my statement here. This text is a part of one of the response over here. One of request response. This eBay deals might be a part of one of the request response. Now, there is a reason here I am asking you to look at each and every request response over here. Each and every response of each request here. Now, this is a request. Now, if you want to look at the response of this particular request here, here copy this particular request, and maybe you can go to this something called generation log here. There should be something called generation log here. 1 minute. Okay, but here it's a bit confusion. Here, code generation, yes, thank you. No, Yes, here in the previous version we call it as a we call it as a script generation. I think that was in a different name. Okay, now it is in the newer version. This is a different name. Okay, now come to this code generation, and here Control F and make use of this particular event here. So we are trying to search for this particular request here. Delete deals.eb.com here. Find next. Now if you look at here, it is showing something. Something about this daily deals over here, deals.eu.com here. Just try to see this maybe an so it is showing something called add event for transaction ID here. It is showing some ID over here for this particular request. It is showing some ID here. Now copy this particular ID here. Now search for it. Now, can you see a response body for transaction? Now, simple thing is, you know, the terminology seems to be kind of a bit problem here. The simple thing is here, what I'm trying to do here. First, I took the first request here. I took this first request. Okay. I copied it. And then I go to this output screen and say I selected this code generation. And in the older version, this might have some script generation, but generation log. There is something called generation log. Okay. Now just go to the start of this generation log. Use Control F and use this particular request. Find next, and you'll for this. No, this is a place where. Now again, let me go to the start of the script here. Now let me find next. Now here, now you find some information here over here. Now for this information, basically there will be an ID here. It means for each event, if you remember during the recording, we had some events, right? For each event, there might be some event for ID here. See, there is an ID. Just make use of this ID. Just copy this ID. Again, go to this. Start of the code generation and paste over here, and again try to search for this ID. Now it is saying that event for transaction with ID here. Actually, we have copied from here itself. It is saying that just an it is talking about the event. It is basically talking about the request of this particular event. In other words, it is saying that this particular transaction is ended here. What is happening? Now see here it is saying that, now if you look at here, response body for this transaction with ID is ended here. It means the above part of this particular one is nothing but request. I'm saying this is a request. Okay. We were searching for this request here in the code generation. And based on this request, we find some transaction ID. Again, we make note of this transaction ID. And based on this transaction ID, we find the response of this particular ID here. See here, it is saying this response body for this transaction is been ended here. It means the above of this one is nothing but it's a response of this one. Okay, saying nothing here. Here it is saying some request header. See here, I'm looking at the response of this particular page. Now, if you see here, response header for this one is, actually, can you see any information over here? No, I don't see good response. That I can understand, that we can understand. Okay. Now, we'll do one thing. 1 minute. See here, I know I'm going again, No, I'm just ignoring all of this. It means I didn't have any important information over here. Okay. Now I'm just ignoring this. Now I can go this one. Like this, you have to follow this particular procedure for all the requests over here. First of all, we make use of this one. We try to take this particular response here. In this response, we did not find any useful information. So that's the reason what we are doing here. Here we can continue. We can go with the next response here. And again, try to copy this. Okay. Try to copy this. And again, here, go to this presentation. And here, try to search for this. Now it is saying, it is talking about this particular transaction. And here it has some ID over here. Okay. Now try to copy this ID. Again, go to the start of this particular code generation and make use of this ID here and say, 1 minute. Yep, see here, we are searching for this transaction with this ID. Here it is saying some request header for this particular transaction. Actually, I don't want to have this request. I want to know the response here. Again, it is saying some request header. Now, here it is talking about some response header. So now, just try to look at this particular information. It's 9:21, right? So just try to look at this particular one, response header and response body. And here, in this particular information, I'm trying to see, if I can find any useful information. If you see here, it has lot of body over here. I'm just copying this particular body over here. Just up to the air, everyone. Now, let me copy this one. Actually, it is a bigger text here. If you look at here, this particular scroll bar is very small. It means it seems that this is a bigger text. I'm trying to copy and I'm trying to paste in your notepad. And in the notepad, I want to just observe here. Come on. Actually, this procedure we have to start till we find a good value over here. Say, for example, we don't find this. In that case, we need to follow, there is something called snapshot. Probably you can go to the snapshot. But first, you have to give the preference for the code generation here. First, you have to give the preference for the code generation. And if in code generation, if you are not able to find out, and then the next preference, probably you can give it to the snapshot view. Here, I'm just trying to copy all this information. Okay, this has been, this is the response of the particular request here. This is the response of this particular request here. Okay, this request seems to be simple here. Okay, this is a request and the response of that particular request is this. Okay, in this response, I'm trying to look at a text over here. Okay, say if you look at here, basically by looking at this, we could not understand anything here. The simple thing, one of the suggestion here, what you can do here, just try to save this particular thing as a HTML page. So go to file, save as, and let me select desktop. Let me say some abc.html. I'm trying to save in HTML format over here, and now go to this desktop over here. Now say ABC and try to see here in this ABC page also. Now we could not see anything properly. One minute, at least let me try to read some content over here. I can't find any proper information over here. It seems everything is being coming from different JavaScripts and all. No use. Again the same procedure. Just try to do, you know what you can do here. Now try to search with this particular request here. Just copy this request and again go to this code generation and go to the top of the code generation and control F and try to search with this one. Find next, and here probably you can find this appropriate transaction ID over here. Just go up over here. Yep, see if there is some transaction ID here, ID 94914. Okay, now here again go to the top and control F and try to search with this transaction ID. Now here again it is showing some request header and search for the response related information. Now this is the place where it is starting with the response header. Now response body here. Now just look at here, here in this response body. Now if you look at here, the title of the page is eBay Daily Deals. Now can you all observe this? Now probably I may make use of a part of the text over here. Everyone try to understand here what I've been trying to do over here. First of all, I'm taking each and every request here. Okay. And I'm trying to find a respective code generation. I'm trying to find respective information in the code generation, and from there I'm trying to find a transaction ID. Based on the transaction ID, I'm finding its response here. Okay. Once I find the response, in that particular response, basically I'm trying to look at some content. Okay. If I can see this content, if I see this content means I'm expecting say this particular content. My expectation is this eBay Daily Deals is my expectation. When we execute this particular script, in the from the server we are going to get something, right? In that something, if you can see this eBay Daily Deals, if we see this particular text, we can conclude that yes, we are getting our actual expected request. We are getting expected response. We can conclude that we are getting expected response, which is nothing but we are getting the expected page. Now see here, I'm making now just see here. Now I'm just copying this particular content. Probably you may take any other content over here. As of now, I'm just taking this particular content over here. Okay. Probably you may use you may take this entire thing, and probably you can see if you can find any other good content here. Probably eBay Deals. Maybe you can take this eBay Deals. Okay. Or maybe you can take any other appropriate content over here. Okay, as of now I'm taking this eBay content over here, eBay Daily Deals. Now for which request we have find this particular response? We find this particular response for this particular request, right? Everyone observe. We find the request for this particular response. Now before this line, what you have to use? You have to use something called reg_find. Okay, you have to use this reg_find. Here you have to give list of attributes. I mean, what is the type of the text that you are finding, and what is the count, what is the variable, in which variable that you want to save. So here, let me open the cell file over here. It is going to have some set of parameters over here, and it is not mandatory that you have to mention all the parameters, and it is not mandatory that you have to use in the same sequence whatever it has been mentioned here. Okay, reg_find over here. Now see here, it is going to show some set of options over here. Seems that they have changed everything here in a newer version. Now see here, under this attribute list, there should be text. Okay, there should be something called text here. Okay, now let me open, try to open this attribute list. Now there should be something called text. Okay, and even we can mention text, text prefix, text here, suffix, search, say count. Yeah, change lot of things. But I'm not sure whether I've been habituated to use loadrunner 11. Maybe might be because of that reason I'm not happy with this, or I'm not sure. I could not really see your text welcome on this one. Basically here we should have some generally we'll be using something like this. Now see here, we'll be using something like this here. I will show what actually I'm talking about. Where is this? Now above this particular transaction we find this, right? Now we'll be using something called web underscore identify. And what is the text that we are trying to see here? Here we wanted to see this particular text. If you find any request with this particular text. Okay. If you find any response with this particular text, we will be computing that. Yes, we are getting the expected response here. Now see here, basically if you can find this eBay daily deals, if you can find this particular eBay daily deals in this particular response here, this is a request, and basically response is not going to shown to us in the script. This response will be there in the background. In the response, if you can see this eBay daily deals, if this eBay daily deals is there, this save count is basically, it's a variable here. You can mention any variable here. Now basically you can say that daily deals CNP. Now this daily deals is a variable. Now this variable is going to be updated with one. Say for example, in the response of this particular request, this is a request, this highlighted is a request. In the response of this particular request, if we have a eBay daily deals, okay, if it is there, this particular variable is going to be updated with one. And say for example, this eBay daily deals is there with four times. Say in this particular response here, in the response of this particular request, say this eBay daily deals is there for four times. Now in that case, this count will become four. Okay, it simply is going to contain the count of this particular text. Okay, now see here, and whatever the concept that I've been explaining, the same concept will also be used in correlation also. Actually, I've been trying to explain. No, I was asking you to look at. I was asking you to come from this first request. I'm asking you to come. I was asking you to copy this, and I was asking you to search in this code generation and make note of transaction ID. Based on the transaction ID, I was asking you to find the response, and in the response, I'm asking you to find some appropriate information. So basically, we find this appropriate information in the third request here. We could not find any special request. Okay, we could not find the appropriate information in this particular request. Basically, we find the appropriate information in this particular request. Okay, in the third request, we find this particular information. So at this, wherever you find, before that line, you have to mention this particular statement over here. Okay, now during the execution, we are saying that we are alerting to the view generator that, okay, in this particular request, we are going to respond, we are going to get a response. In that response, we are expecting this eBay daily deals. We are mentioning this. Okay, if you are getting that, we can conclude that yes, we are getting a required, we are getting an expected page, expected response from the application. Okay, now here, now obviously here I am making use of this variable. I said this is a variable here, and here this is going to contain some syntax. A text means what is the text that you are trying to find, and save count means it is whatever you are going to mention here, it is going to be like a variable. And here in this case, as of now, I mentioned two variables here, and if you want to say that, I know these are the two variables that these are the two parameters I want to make use of. Right? I know at the final you can mention last here. Apart from these two, if you go to this help file here, see, apart from these two, there will be some more parameters available here. Now, if you want to look at them, there is something called attribution list. Where is that? Where is showing? Attribute list. Okay. In this web underscore reg underscore find, basically we can use some set of attributes. One of the attributes is text. What is the type? What is the text that you want to fetch? What is the text that you want to look at? And there is something like text prefix. You can look at the prefix of a particular text. Okay. And here there is a save count. Okay. And there is something called search. Search means where you want to look at, where you want to see. If you remember, we had a response body, response header. If you look at here, by using the transaction ID, you are tracing it out, right? So at that time, you are mentioning some body and header. Okay. So in which part you want to look at? Header, body. If you don't mention it, it is going to search in entire thing here. Okay. Save count. If you see here, save count. And I said the number of matches that were found. And I said, if you remember, if it counts if it finds EB daily deals as 4 times, this variable is going to be updated with 4 value as 4. Okay. Now here, see here. Now, where is this? So, this is the variable. Now, if I want to find what is the, how many values, how many EB daily deals is being registered as part of this daily deals, if I want to know about this information. Now, see here, as a transaction, and if you closely observe here, basically throughout our classes, this is one of the topic is a bit complex, but once you start practicing, it is also easy, and the same concept will also be applicable for correlation. Okay, by next class, make sure you practice the same thing. However, see here, we have to discuss some more things here. Now, see here, this is the variable. I said this is the variable which is going to contain the number of occurrences, occurrences of that particular string. Okay, if it finds for 2 times, it is going to say 2. If it is going to find for 3 times, it is going to say 3. At least now we are expecting at least greater than 0. Greater than 0 means it can be 1, it can be 2, it can be 3. If it finds at least for 1 time, we can conclude that yes, we reached our expected page over here. Now how can I, now this is a, whatever this variable is basically a load runner related variable. Now try to understand. This daily deals CNT is a load runner related variable here, and I said here in load runner we are going to use C language. I cannot directly say that, I cannot directly mention that if this variable die greater than 0, I cannot directly mention like this. Why I cannot directly mention like this? Because this daily deals CNT, this variable is, it's not a directly C variable, it is a load runner related variable. Try to understand my terminology over here. This is not a C variable, this is a load runner related variable. So now here we have to convert this load runner related variable into C variable here. Load runner related variable into C variable. If you want to convert load runner variable into C variable, there is something called LR underscore string here. Okay. Here you need to mention, this is a value, and again flower basis, and this is a value, and now this is basically, this highlighted line is going to convert this daily deals count into a C variable here. Now if you want to convert into, now generally it is going to contain an integer. Now here in C variable, here integer can be represented like this, ICNT. Now this ICNT is a C variable. And in this C variable, I'm trying to capture a value which has been converting. This is a load runner variable. I'm converting this load runner value into a C variable here. So if you want to convert, there is something called LR underscore eval underscore string over here. Now here, see here, if this CNT is greater than 0 over here, if this CNT is greater than 0, what we can say here, we can say that this LR underscore end transaction, in the earlier case, in the other case, we were using LR underscore transaction underscore auto over here. Now if it is greater than 0, I can say directly here pass, else I will say it is a fail. Okay. If you remember here in the earlier case, we were just using LR underscore auto. Now we are giving kind of a confident transaction pass. Either pass or fail, we are giving it confidently because we are checking it through some variables. We are just checking whether the correct response is getting up or not. One minute. I hope everyone knows at least the basics. Actually, you know, there is a session to, I'm planning to take basics of C language, but I hope by that time, at least I hope everyone can understand what is this int, what is this variable and all. Okay. And I hope everyone can handle with the C even if condition. Is there anyone who don't know at least the basics of C language? At least basics of any programming language over here? I know here I've been used a bit of C language over here. Yep. Here, you know, we have to discuss, I know this size int is a variable of integer. Okay, we have to discuss something about this, and we have to discuss about this, and of course, I know I may need to give some more information on this eval string. As of now, I know have some perception like eval string means it is going to convert a load runner variable into a C variable over here, and this is a integer over here. Okay, integer means say it is a whole number. For those people who don't know the basics of C, you can just say it is a number here. Okay. This number is, if this number is greater than 0 here, I'm saying pass. And I'm saying else condition, if this number is not greater than 0, I can say it is a fail over here. Okay. Now let us, I think I saved it. And moreover here, just to understand over here, we'll try to print some output message over here. Give a minute. Here I am trying to print something called. Here, we'll be discussing what is LR underscore output message also. Don't worry about all these things. If you look at here in the syllabus, I already listed down what is this eval string. Okay. And of course, today we understood the start transition and transition. We'll be understanding this eval string and we'll be understanding this LR underscore output message. Okay. And if you see here, we'll be understanding this data types. Data types is nothing but this int. Float. We'll be discussing this kind of information. Okay, don't worry. Here, there is a plan, but actually, for this particular scenario, we have to use these things. Okay, that's the reason I'm using all these things. Okay, we'll be discussing all these things. Don't worry. Now, let me save this and let us try to run this particular script now. Let me go to this replay. Actually, I'm running out of time for other class. we'll give for 2 or 3 minutes. We'll give a try for 2 or 3 minutes. Seeing some problem over here. Not yet showing illegal statement termination. Let me do one thing. And then let me say ICNT. Okay. Now again, replay. Let me say compile. That's it. Now it seems now same things are there. Yeah. Sometimes you know if you declare in middle, sometimes it may not accept. Let me do something. Let me add. Let me declare at the top of the script here. Okay. Now we are again try to compile. See it. You know, if I declare at the top of the script here, it is not throwing any error here. Okay. I am doing some mistake over here. Let me look into this. Yeah, no. If I'm doing a mistake here, 1 minute. Okay then, I know actually I'm running out of time. We'll continue with this. I know don't get worry about this. The simple thing is what we are actually trying to do here from your script. From our script, basically we are making note of this particular request. And we are going to this code generation over here. That is here in the output section. There is something called a code generation. In this code generation, we are searching for this. And based on this, we are trying to find some transaction ID. And based on the transaction ID, we are finding some response. In that response, we are looking at the page related content here. Basically, I was trying to look at the page related content here. Okay, I was trying to look at the page related content over here. Actually, in this case, if you remember, I was taking this title of the page, eBay Daily Deals here. Okay, so take some reference in this particular page. How I am taking this? By looking at the response of the request. And what is that request? Because here for this particular page we have lot of requests, so we started from the first request. Okay, for the first request we try to look at the response, but we don't find anything. And for the second request we looked at the content again. For the second request also we did not find anything. And for the third request we find something here, we find some information. So that's the reason before this third request, we are going to mention something called web underscore file here. So whenever we are trying to execute the script, whenever we are going to get the response from the server, so we are going to validate that whether this eBay Daily Deals is there in that particular response or not. If it is there, this count will be increased. And if we find for 5 times, this count will be increased, will be mentioned as fine. It means this count is going to represent the number of occurrences of this particular text here. Basically, we are expecting at least one time. Okay, now this is a load runner related variable. I cannot use the directly. I cannot use this load runner variable directly here in our script. Okay, so we are converting this load runner variable into this C understandable language here. Okay, that can be done using something called eval here. Actually, here whatever now we discussed, if you are able to understand this, I can say you are almost done with this view generator. Because you will be having same kind of concept will be there in correlation also. Similar approach will also be there in correlation. Okay, if you understand these particular topics and if you understand these functions, what are the functions that I have written here, like if condition, eval string, and I was using some set of things here, right? If you are able to understand those things, I can say you are done with these things. Yep. You know, next class we'll continue with this from here.
Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.